Today's video is brought to you by Spikes Academy, which is launching a new course, The Art of Sideboarding, with Seth Manfield. And the first 200 students can get 15% off with the code SIDEBOARDING. You can join the Academy at spikesacademy.com. Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech. So as you know, Monday means it's Modern Monday here in Instant Deck Tech land, and we have a spicy one to look at today. I'm calling this one Hit Yourself Boros, a deck that's looking to play some creatures that like to be dealt damage for some reason, and then deal those creatures damage and use it to our advantage. And it comes to us from Jeff Opgard, who did get to a top 8 finish in a 50-ish player modern tournament. So, I mean, not massive, but not really small either. So congrats to Jeff on a really unique deck. A quick reminder before we break down Hit Yourself Boros for modern. If you enjoy this deck and you want to see it made to videos, take a minute, click the like button, the subscribe button, leave a comment, anything you can do to support your deck, because whichever deck is most popular gets a shot at being made into videos next week. So step one of this deck is creatures that like to be dealt damage, and we kick things off with Boros Reckoner, and then Bad Boros Reckoner, probably better known as Spite Mare, just essentially Boros Reckoner with one more mana and less abilities. But the big deal here isn't that these are three powered creatures, it's that whenever these creatures are dealt damage, we get to deal that much damage to something else. So the idea of this deck is we're going to play these creatures, and they're just going to get dealt damage in combat, or maybe our opponent accidentally lightning bolts them. No, we're going to try to deal a bunch of damage to them and use that to win the game. Joining our Reckoners, we have everyone's favorite Swans of Vert Urgul. So you probably remember this one, an infamous budget deck we played in the past that was a combo deck. This deck is not a combo deck with Swans. It's more just for value. It works well with the damage your own stuff theme, because whenever it's dealt damage, the damage is prevented, and the controller of that damage draws that many cards. So if we lightning bolt a Swans, we draw three or whatever. So these are the creatures that we primarily want to be damaging. So let's assume we get these creatures on the battlefield. How do we use these creatures to actually win the game? And here we have a couple of plans. So our most direct combo is pretty janky, Volcano Helion. So Volcano Helion, really unique creature. When it comes into play, we get to choose any amount of damage, any amount. We could choose a billion if we want to, and we deal that much damage to a creature and also to ourselves. So obviously, if we can deal that much damage to Boros Reckoner, we just kill our opponent. We choose a trillion, our opponent takes a trillion from Boros Reckoner. The problem is, we would also take a trillion and die. The secret is Worship. So if we can get down Worship to go along with this plan, damage that would be dealt to us only puts us to one. So we could choose a trillion, our opponent takes a trillion, we go to one, even though we take a trillion, and we win the game on the spot. So Volcano Helion can choose really big numbers, kill our opponent combo-wise with Worship, or just be like, choose 10, 10 to Boros Reckoner, 10 to our opponent, or choose 15, 15 to Swans, draw 15 cards. So that's kind of combo piece number one. Then we have a bunch of additional ways to damage our own stuff. Pyrohemia, the red version of Pestilence, just pay one damage to each creature and each player. Obviously, we're kind of doubling that up if we have Boros Reckoners, drawing cards if we have Swans. If all of the creatures on the battlefield go away, so does Pyrohemia, but we got some tricks to get around that. Blasphemous Act, kind of a traditional combo with Boros Reckoner, just 13 damage to everything, gets cheaper if there's a lot of creatures. So if we have two Boros Reckoner effects or Spite Mare effects, Blasphemous Act should just be lethal. 26 damage at our opponent's face. Nahiri's Wrath, we discard a bunch of cards, deal a bunch of damage to things, kind of another version of Blasphemous Act almost if we have some expensive cards in hand. And then Pyroclasm, 2 damage to everything, which again triggers our Boros Reckoner, our Spite Mare, our Swans of Vert Urgul. So these are our main damage cards. So that's kind of the end of the deck. Stuff that wants to be hit, and then stuff to hit that stuff. Then we have some other creatures that are kind of support creatures. These are creatures that don't really combo with damage the way like a Boros Reckoner does, but they still serve a pretty important role in this deck. So Hazoreth the Fervent, it's indestructible, which means no matter how much damage is being dealt to it, it's going to stick around, which also means something like Pyrohemia is going to stick around and not go away, because we'll always have that creature on the battlefield. Plus, it's a pretty big threat, just a 5-4 hasty indestructible, not bad. And then Oriok Champion and Burrington Forge Tender, kind of similar to Hazoret. Not nearly as aggressive, but because of protection from red, Pyrohemia, Blasphemous Act, all that stuff doesn't kill it, so we just sit on the battlefield, make sure we always have a creature out there, gain some random life with Oriok Champion, and make sure our Pyrohemia is going to stick around to deal as much damage as possible. Otherwise, Wall of Omens, doesn't really combo, doesn't do anything with damage, isn't indestructible, just draws us a card, slows down the game in the early game. Lightning Bolt, Path to Exile, some targeted removal. Bolt can also go at Swans to draw some cards, turning it into a red Ancestral Recall. Speaking of drawing cards, light up the stage, more card advantage. Chandra, also for card advantage, but can deal damage to creatures in a pinch if we just really need that 4 damage. Rest in peace, it does literally nothing with our deck, but it is really good in Modern right now. Arclight Phoenixes, Dredge, two of the top decks in the format. Main deck Rest in Peace actually makes a lot of sense in our current metagame, so it doesn't work with our combo, just a utility card that's good against the meta. Mana base wise, bunch of fetches, some shock lands, some Clifftop Retreats, some basic lands. In the sideboard, Blood Moon for Trons and also just to jank people out. Leyline of Sanctity to protect ourselves from combo. Our main deck, it is pretty slow, dangerously so perhaps against decks like Storm. Leyline buys us a lot of time there. Stony Silence for Hardened Scales, Affinity, Tron, Wear Tear, Artifacts, and Enchantments. Some more Graveyard Hate with Grafdigger's Cage and Rest in Peace. Boil to just catch control decks by surprise, maybe get rid of all of their islands at instant speed. Pithing Needle, Blessed Alliance, kind of all-purpose catch-all effects. Blessed Alliance, some life gain thrown in. And that is Hit Yourself Boros for Modern. And that's better instant deck for today. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will talk to you soon. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.